Hello everyone and welcome back to another album review. And in this video I'm going to review Patchouli Blue by Boren and their Club of Gore. Boren and their Club of Gore is a jazz band that has been releasing albums for about 2 decades, and it's one of the more well-known underground acts of jazz music, getting closer to the term of dark jazz, incorporating elements of dark ambient into their music. Now, for those who are unfamiliar with Boren and their Club of Gore, I think they're a quite intriguing band, containing members that were formerly into underground and obscure hardcore punk and grindcore bands, and then all of them coming up together providing some of the smoothest material in jazz music you can find recently, but having a really dark and unsettling aura to them in some occasions. Some of their more well-known works are albums like
Sunset Mission.
I really like the atmosphere to this album. It is a perfect album for a rainy day where you're just home alone and you just want to relax. It is a relaxing album, but it also gives a dark aura to the whole sound, like a film noir aesthetic, like you're in a sort of old school movie about drugs and mafia, or just a mystery movie with a psychological thriller vibe to it. Its smoothness though can also give you a sexy attitude, especially with the beautiful saxophone, which is incorporated a lot in each one of the albums of Boren and their Club of Gore. This is also something that is included here, but what you see with some of the more recent works from Boren and their Club of Gore is that they tend to go a bit more into the dark ambient roots. It still has the dark aura, but it's a bit different in their later works, just incorporating more the elements of dark ambient and in a sense going a bit more away from the jazz roots and just giving a more outwardly and out there experience. You can just see from the album cover that this is pretty much the case. We're not talking about your basic and typical smooth jazz album. There are multiple calming and smooth scenes in this album. There are some really nice bass lines. The drums are still a bit the same, kind of soft, kind of into the more repetitive fashion. But you know, other than those small differences in the vibe of the album, in general, it pretty much has all of the elements you would expect from a Boren and their Club of Gore album. So for those who have heard stuff of the band, getting into this brand new album, you pretty much know what you're going to expect. And in my opinion, as far as I like the whole atmosphere Boren and their Club of Gore create with their albums, I still haven't found this album that in its whole would manage to amaze me. Even the album I have,
Sunset Mission,
I think it's a really good album. I really like the album, but it's definitely a lengthy one, and at times it can get a bit repetitive, especially with the drums. All of those elements land on Patchouli Blue as well. We still get a sort of a lengthy album. It's kind of repetitive at points, and you definitely don't get something that much different compared to anything they've done so far. But I still think we have a really nice work over there. Instead, I would say that this is one of the better works they've done so far. I mean, I definitely like this more than their previous work, Piano Nights, which it was still a decent album, but that was pretty much about it. On the other hand, I would say that Patchouli Blues has some really strong highlights to it, like its introduction, Total False. I think it's a very nice way it starts the album, and I like the pacing and the whole structure to this song. And it's actually with some of the longer tracks where I truly see some of the best moments in this album, like the self-titled one, Patchouli Blue, that goes for 9 minutes long. This is a gorgeous track, one of my favorites from recent works from Boren and their Club of Gore, and goddamn, this saxophone, it just sounds so sexy. Other highlight has to be the 7-minute Zach Mir V-Lang. And also on the shorter side of the spectrum we have the track Tief Gesunken. These were mainly the tracks that stood out to me. And like I said, I think with some of the dark ambient elements we get some really decent works outside this entire album, but there were definitely some others that for mainly some of the same reasons they just didn't manage to bring that much to the whole album, like the tracks Deine Küsne and Vergessen et Vorbei. I think that those two songs in particular towards half point through the album, they were kind of decent, but I think that at some moments the electronics just felt kind of flat, kind of stale. And in general, there are other moments like Zwei Herzen aus Gold and Meine Willis Son that just end up being to the okay side of things. This is another album from Born Under Club of Gore that I truly enjoyed. This is a really solid work, once again, from the band. Like I said, if you have heard previous works from the band, you know what to expect, you know what you're going for, you're going to get another dark jazz album, just the way Born Under Club of Gore managed to do best, with their own way. But for me, once again, other than this solid and smooth dark jazz album, this is pretty much it. It's another album that just doesn't manage to extend to something far more than just another enjoyable work. I'm going to give Patchouli Blue a 7- out of 10. What's your opinion on this album? Like it? Dislike it? Why? And what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.